What's up, people? It's time once again for another Father's Day in 3 days on Sunday, and it's a tradition here on Keys to the Castle Music on holidays where I do a video featuring songs related to that holiday, and this year is no different, coming at you with another video on songs about dads or having to do with dads. I'm not a father, but I've definitely been a daddy to some women. Way to make it weird. Let's get to the songs about dads. When I first saw the title of the opening song, my mind completely went somewhere else, and I had to double-check the lyrics just to make sure. This song was on this artist's debut album in 1971 called Just As I Am. That's the album that has his huge hit song Ain't No Sunshine that reached number 3 and catapulted his career in music after laboring away as an aircraft mechanic. If it wasn't for that song, he was seriously going to quit music because it felt like he was getting nowhere. Don't I know the feeling. Although Ain't No Sunshine and this song are generally about an older man trying to maintain a relationship with a younger woman, the song I'm featuring here has a much different context. This song is about finding out he has a daughter for the first time 6 years after she was born. The song is I'm Her Daddy by Bill Withers from 1971.
Is she pretty? Has she grown? Does she sleep well?
This next song was written to celebrate the birth of this artist's daughter, Aisha. Most of the instruments played on this track were played by this artist except some of the keyboards, which is ironic because that's his main instrument. When it was released, it was over 6 minutes and wasn't released as a single because of it. It was later edited down to just over 3 minutes and charted at number 94 in the UK 36 years later due to download sales after a performance of it at the Diamond Jubilee concert for Queen Elizabeth II. But it never reached its full potential on the charts, despite being one of his most loved songs. It did, however, reach number 23 in the adult contemporary charts because it was getting a lot of airplay on the radio. Don't feel bad for him, though, because by that time he already had 30 top 40 hits, including 5 number 1 hits. The song is Isn't She Lovely by Stevie Wonder from 1976. Up next is an artist that many consider to be underrated, and she just hasn't seemed to have gotten a lot of industry praise because she's not as flashy as some of our other music artists because she's a singer-songwriter. She has released 16 studio albums and has had a very successful 30-plus year career, and this was one of the songs that started all of that on her debut album called Little Earthquakes. This song was inspired by her father and a conversation she had with him about being able to accept herself and being good enough for her, although the meaning changes from time to time when her perspective and experiences change, although she said that when she performs it live, it still always goes back to her vision of her relationship with her father. The song is Winter by Tori Amos from 1992.
Snow can wait, I forgot my mittens. Wipe my nose, get my new boots on. I get a little warm in my heart when I think of winter. I put my hand in my father's. was close.
Now we get to the song in the video that's probably the biggest tearjerker, because it's a song about a father that lost his 4-year-old son in a tragic event, falling out of a window that was 53 stories high. Unless you've been living in a cave, you most likely have heard this song a million times. This artist wasn't sure he wanted to release the song, but the director of a film convinced him to put it in the movie Rush because she thought it might help people with their own tragic stories. At the 1993 Grammy Awards, it won for Record of the Year, Song of the Year, and Best Male Pop Vocal. It's also his highest charting original song, coming in at number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100. He has a number 1 hit, but it's a cover song of I Shot the Sheriff by Bob Marley. The song is Tears in Heaven by Eric Clapton from 1992.
Would you know my name if I saw you?
Up next is a song about a father and son relationship. It's made up, but it's definitely inspired by the artist's relationship with his own father. His father owned a restaurant in London, and the artist worked there as a waiter until he signed a record contract at the very young age of 17. The song is about a father wanting his son to follow in the family business footsteps and finding a girl and settling down because he thinks it's the path to happiness, because it's what's worked for him. But what he doesn't realize is that his son has his own plans and dreams. Their relationship in real life was one of a loving father and son, and they had no animosity towards each other regarding their own hopes and desires, though. The artist was quoted in Entertainment Weekly as saying, "The song is a testament to the differences we represent to each other, especially in age and traditions. Traditions have a big impact on our lives, and sometimes you've got to walk away." The song is Father and Son by Cat Stevens from 1970.
It's not time to make a change, just relax. Take it easy, you're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to know. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something going on. But take your time, think a lot. Why, think of everything you've got, for you will still be here tomorrow, but your dreams may not.
The second to last song in this video is the song that gives me all the best music feels in comparison to the other songs here. Surprise, it's another song from the 70s. I love the 80s for its pop culture, but I love the 70s for the quality of the songwriting. The makers of the Guardians of the Galaxy seem to love the 70s for its songwriting as well, because they included a bunch of songs from the 70s in their movie soundtrack, and it includes this song. The song promotes the idea to a child that things are gonna get easier. Boy, did they lie, but it's still a great song. The song is Ooh Child by the Five Stair Steps from 1970. All right, so like I said, the previous song gives me all the best music feels, but this final song is probably my favorite song in this video just from the story and lyrics. I like the melody too, but there's still an overall feeling to the other parts. Although this isn't this artist's biggest song, it definitely battles it out for the most emotional one in my opinion. And that's saying a lot because he has a bunch of emotionally charged songs. It's also a skill to be able to do that with such items in the songs as fries, roast beef, and Coca-Cola. There's some free promotion. Hit me up because I could use some. If there's at least one indulgence that I have, it's Coca-Cola. A little bit of that other Coke too. Just kidding. Anyway, I just love the way this song makes me feel like I'm laying in a bed with a comforting blanket of razor blades on top of me. There are some people that literally like that stuff, but that's another website. Way to make it weird again. The song is Still Fighting It by Ben Folds from 2002.
Good morning, son. I am a bird wearing a brown polyester shirt. You want a Coke? Maybe some fries? The roast beef combo's only $9.95. It's a
All right, folks, that's another Father's Day in the books. To all the fathers out there, have a happy Father's Day. Be good to your kids, and I hope they're good to you, and I'll see you next week on Thursday at 1 p.m. with a new video.